Hi, in this video, I'm going to cover the journal entries that we do to record the sales of inventory under the perpetual method. On March 2nd, East Company sold $900,000 in merchandise to West Company. The cost of the merchandise sold was $620,000. So we are doing the sales journal entries here, and so we are East Company in this situation. And so on March 2nd, to record the sale, we would debit accounts receivable and credit sales revenue for the $900,000. Now we know this isn't a cash sale because they gave us terms. You wouldn't need terms if somebody had already paid you in cash. So even though you don't see those words on account that you're used to seeing, terms tell you that it is not a cash sale. Now, under the perpetual method, every time we make a sale, we also have to record cost of goods sold. So there's going to be a second journal entry on this date to debit cost of goods sold and credit inventory for the original cost of that inventory. The $620,000 is what it cost East Company to obtain that inventory when they bought it. And so at this point, we now have an expense to show that we've used up that inventory, so to speak, by selling it, and that expense is called cost of goods sold. Now we can see we have our sales revenue and our accounts receivable. Those both reflect the sales price of our inventory. And our cost of goods sold and our inventory, our cost of goods sold is increasing while our inventory account is decreasing. Next, on March 6th, West Company returned $90,000 in merchandise. The cost of the returned merchandise was $62,000. So $90,000 of the merchandise that they bought from us is being returned. And so when we have a return, we debit an account called Sales Returns and Allowances. And we credit accounts receivable because they aren't going to pay us for something that they've returned. Sales Returns and Allowances is a contra revenue account. That means that it sits next to our revenues in our income statement, but it actually decreases our revenues overall. Now, since we return that merchandise, we need to also record that in our journals. And so to record that return, we're going to debit inventory, we're going to put it back into inventory, and we're going to credit cost of goods sold because we didn't actually sell it. And so we can see here now that we have a new account called Sales Returns and Allowances that has a debit. Our accounts receivable balance is going down because they owe us less money. And then we're going to put the $62,000 back into the inventory and reduced cost of goods sold for that amount. And now we have the new balances for all these accounts. Next, on March 12th, East Company received payment on the balance from West Company. So the first thing we need to do is check whether or not we're in the discount period. We received the payment on March 12th. So we need to go back to our original entry in the original terms to check whether or not we're in our discount period. So our original entry says that they sold on March 2nd. So March 2nd to March 12th is 10 days and we are in our discount period. And our terms are 210 net 30. So because they paid us within 10 days, they receive a 2% discount. That discount is taken on the total amount that they owe us. So the amount that they owe us is the $810,000 because they returned some of their merchandise. So the total amount of the discount will be $16,200. Now that we've calculated the discount, we can do the journal entry. We're going to credit accounts receivable for the full balance that they owe us because they're paying off their entire bill. However, they're not going to pay us all of that in cash because they received that discount. So we're going to debit sales discount for $16,200. And then we debit cash because we're going to get paid the remaining of that in cash from West Company. Sales discount is also another contra revenue account. It hangs with the revenues in the income statement, but it decreases revenues overall. And so now we can see we need to add in a sales discounts account, and we would show our payment of the accounts receivable, decreasing our accounts receivable. So on this overall transaction with West Company, our net sales ends up at $793,800. So in summary, sales revenue is a revenue account, and that's what we use to record our sales of merchandise. Cost of goods sold is an expense account, and it shows the cost of the inventory that we have sold. And then we have two contra revenue accounts, sales returns and allowances, and sales discounts. Both of these are netted against our sales to help us calculate net sales for our financial statements.